sir. I am Janice Arcadio, one of the reporter of Chapter 11, the French Benefit Tax. French Benefits. Under labor laws, French benefits pertain to all other benefits or incentives of employees other than the basic pay. The basic pay is the fixed regular salary or wages of employees every payroll period. Under the NIRC or National Internal Revenue Code, the term French benefit was defined to pertain to goods, services, or other benefits furnished by the employer to the employees. FBT is the abbreviation for French benefits tax. A French benefit is a non-monetary benefit payment made to an employee on top of their normal salary or wages. FBT is paid by the employers on certain benefits, not the employee. Tax treatment of French benefits. Under current tax rules, however, items of French benefits in the strict sense are treated differently depending on their nature. For example, A. French benefits that are fixed every payroll period are considered regular compensation. For example, fixed transportation allowance. B. French benefits that are variable and performance-based are considered supplemental compensation. For example, commission, profit sharing, and overtime pay. C. French benefits in the form of incentives are considered 13th-month pay and a safety other benefits. D. French benefits furnished for the employer's convenience or necessity are exempt from the income tax. Other French benefits. As mentioned in the previous chapter, other French benefits not included or classifiable as items of compensation income in which are not exempted under the law are treated as follows. First, for rank and file employees, included as other benefits under 13th month pay in other benefits. Second, for managerial and supervisory employees, excluded in compensation income and are subjected to final French benefit tax. Scope of French benefit tax. The French benefit tax covers only the taxable French benefits of managerial or supervisory employees. A rank and file employee is an employee who is holding neither managerial nor supervisory position. A managerial employee, on the other hand, is vested with powers or prerogatives to lay down and execute management shall policies or to hire, transfer, suspend, lay off, recall, or discipline employees. A supervisory employees are those who, in the interest of the employer, effectively recommend such as managerial actions if the exercise of such authority is not merely rationally or clerical in nature but requires the use of independent judgment. For purposes of the French benefit tax, RR 398 clarifies that taxable French benefits exclude those items considered as compensation income. Hence, an excellent understanding of the items of compensation income is extremely important in highlighting the bounds between compensation income and the French benefit subject to French benefit tax. Employee personal expenses. When an expense takes the nature of an employee, personal expense or expenditure is paid or assumed by the employer in default of an approximate business necessity, it is deemed a French benefit in its entirety even if the expense is accepted in the name of the employer. Illustration. Mr. Lakewood, a managerial expatriate employee, was granted by the employer a 30,000 pesos monthly housing allowance in addition to his regular salary. The actual monthly rent of Mr. Lakewood's residence is 25,000 pesos. The 25,000 personal expense assumed by the employer constitutes a taxable French benefit subject to French benefit tax. The monthly fixed 5,000 pesos excess is a taxable additional compensation. Hybrid expenses. When the employer incurs expenses which is purported partly for business and partly for employee's incentive, only 50% of the expense representing the employee incentive is subject to the French benefit tax. The following are hybrid expenses under RR 3998. First, housing benefits in the form of rental accommodation. When an employer leases a residential unit for the use of employee in the business, the rental expense is then half business expense and half French benefits to the employee. Second, allowing an employee free use of business property. When an employer allows its employee to use business properties, The rental value of depreciation value of the business property over the period of usage is deemed of half business expense and half French benefit to the employee. The French benefit tax is a final tax imposed on the French benefit furnished, granted, or paid by the employer to the employee, except rank and file employee, whether such employer is an individual, a professional partnership, or a corporation, regardless of whether the corporation is taxable or not, or the government in its instrumentalities. For the purposes of the French benefit tax, the French benefit means any good, service, or other benefits furnished or granted in cash or in kind by the employer to individual employees, except rank and file employees, such as, but not limited to the following. First, housing benefits. Second, expense account. Third, vehicles of any kind. Fourth, household personnel such as maid, driver, or others. Fifth, interest for the difference between the market rate, 12%, and the actual interest granted. Sixth, membership fees, dues and other expenses borne by the employer for the employee in social and athletic clubs or other similar organization. Seventh, expense for foreign travel. 8. Holiday and vacation expenses. 9. Educational assistance to the employee of his dependents. 10. Life or health and other non-life insurance, premiums or similar accounts in excess of what the law allows. General categories of French benefits subject to final tax. First, management perquisite benefits. Second, employee personal expenses shouldered by the employer. Third, taxable de minimis benefits. A. Excess de minimis over their limits. B. Benefits not included in the de minimis list. The characteristics of the French benefit tax are as follows. First, final tax. The French benefit tax is a final tax that is withheld by the employer at the source. This means that the employee does not need to report the French benefits in their income tax return. Second, tax upon managerial or supervisory employees. The French benefit tax is not a tax on the employer, but rather a tax on the French benefit reserved by the managerial or supervisory employee. It applies regardless of the identity of the employer, whether it is a sole, proprietorship, partnership, corporation, taxable or exempt, or the government. Third, paid by the employer. As a final tax, the French benefit tax is presumed to be withheld at the source and remitted by the employer to the government. Fourth, gross-up tax. The monetary value or amount of the French benefit received by the employee is effectively net off the final tax that is withheld at the source. The monetary value is first grossed up by the complement percentage of the applicable French benefit tax rate before the tax rate is applied. Fifth, due quarterly. The French benefit tax is due for remittance quarterly based on the accounting period, fiscal or calendar, selected by the employer. The monetary value of each taxable French benefit is determined and reported quarterly through the BIR Form 163-3Q. The quarterly French benefit tax is due on or before the last day of the month following the quarter in which withholding was made. Procedures in computing the French benefit tax. Determine the monetary value. Monetary value refers to the taxable amount of benefits taken home or realized by the managerial or supervisory employee. The monetary value is presumed net of the final tax. Second, determine the gross-up rate and French benefit tax rate applicable for the taxpayer. The gross-up rate, the complement of the French benefit tax rate. If the French benefit tax rate is 35%, the gross-up rate is 100% less 35%, or 65%. If the French benefit tax rate is 25%, the gross-up rate is 75%. Third, determine the gross-up monetary value by dividing the monetary value by the gross-up rate. Fourth, determine the French benefit tax by multiplying the French benefit tax rate to the gross-up monetary value. Example, cost or book value lesser than fair market value. If the cost or book value of the assigned residential house subject to depreciation allowance is lesser than its fair market value, the excess amount should be amortized throughout the remaining estimated useful life of the residential property. Assume the following data related to the residential property assigned to the manager of beauty company. Fair market value, 6 million. Zonal value, 5 million. Book value, 4 million. Remaining estimated useful life of the building, 10 years. The French benefit tax is computed as follows. Fair market value, higher amount, 6 million pesos, less cost or book value of real property, 4,200,000. The excess amount is 1,800,000 pesos, divided by remaining useful life in years, which is 10 years, and the annual amortization is 1,800 pesos, divided by the gross-up monetary factor, which is 68%. And then the gross-up monetary is 264,706 pesos, multiplied by the French benefit tax, which is 32%. And then the French benefit tax is 84,706 pesos. Journal entry, the annual French benefit would be French benefit expense is 264,706. And the cash or French benefit tax is 84,706. The income constructively realized is 180,000. And then the annual amortization of 180,000 pesos decreases taxable income, and the income constructively received increases taxable income with the same amount. Accordingly, the only amount affecting the taxable income is the French benefit tax due of 84,706 pesos. The alternative journal entry would be the French benefit expense is 84,706, and in the cash or French benefit tax payable is 84,706. Rules on valuation of French benefits. First, benefits paid in cash. When benefit is given in cash or paid for in cash, the monetary value is the amount paid for in cash. Note, the only exception here is when the employer pays for the rent of the residence of the employee. Monetary value is 50% of the rental payment. Second, benefits paid in kind. When benefits is given in kind, the monetary value is the fair value of the thing given unless its book value is higher. Book value is the cost less any provision for depreciation for depreciable properties. Simply stated, the monetary value is the fair value or the book value of the thing given, whichever is higher. When ownership over the property is transferred to the employee, the monetary value is the entire fair value of the property, even if the property is partially used in the business of the employer. Benefits that are furnished. When the benefit is given in the form of free use of the employer's property, the monetary value is 50% of the rental value of the property. If the property has no available rental value, the depreciation value is used. For purposes of the depreciation value, the presumptive useful lives of the property are A. 20 years for real properties. Hence, the depreciation value is computed as 1 to 20 or 5% of the value of the property. B. 5 years for movable properties. Hence, the depreciation value is computed as 1 to 5 or 20% of the value of the property.
So, hello sir, I am Christian Dale Tita now and I am the second reporter and this is the continuation of the report of Miss Janice Arcadio. And today, I'll be tackling about the special guidelines on monetary value determination. Taxable housing benefits. Employer leases a residential property for the use of his employee and the said property is the usual residence of the employee. So monetary value is equals to 50% of the benefits. Illustration. A sole proprietorship business leases a residential house and lot for the use of his business manager for 20,000 a month. So the monetary value shall be quarterly value is equal to 20,000 times 3 months is equivalent to 60,000. And quarterly monetary value is equal to 60,000 times 50% is equal to 30,000. Expense account. Expenses incurred by an employee by which are paid by his employer or incurred and paid by employee but reimbursed or advanced by the employer are taxable French benefits. The monetary value is the amount paid by the employer. So number one of this is properly documented employer expense. So when the expense is receipted for and in the name of the employer and the expenditure does not partake of the nature of a personal expense attributable to the employee, it is not a taxable fringe benefit because it is a business expense. So personal expenses of the employee, such as the groceries for personal consumption of the employer and or his family, if paid or reimbursed by the employer, are taxable fringe benefits whether or not received in the name of the employer. Fixed and regular rata are treated as a part of a regular compensation income and are subject to creditable withholding taxes, not to fringe benefit tax. Illustration. Denver Corporation paid for the following expenses which were liquidated by its managerial employee. Water and electricity bill at manager's home, $15,000. Meals and groceries at manager's home, $10,000. Bill on business telephone, $2,000. Bill on personal phone, $1,000. Transportation from office to and from clients, $12,000. Transportation from office to and from manager's home, $10,000. Foods and beverages for visiting business clients, $8,000. So the monetary value of fringe benefit shall be computed as follows. So water and electricity bill at director's home, $15,000. Meals and groceries at director's home, $18,000. Bill on personal phone, $1,000. And transportation from office to and from home, $10,000. So the total monetary value is 44,000 pesos. So note, business telephone bills, office to clients transportation, and food and beverages for client visitors are business expense. Not the fringe benefit to the manager. Kay kuan man, silbi sa manager, jud ni siya kuan kay own gasto man niya. Kay lahi mo butong sa iya ha, lahi po lang sa business. Motor vehicles of any kind. Purchase by employer of motor vehicle in the name of the employee, regardless of whether the same is used partially in the business of the employer. Monetary value is equivalent to 100% of the cost of the motor vehicle. Note that the monetary value shall be reported in the quarter of purchase. Purchase of car on installment basis by the employer with ownership placed in the name of the employee, even if the car is used partly for the employer's business. The benefit is the acquisition cost divided by 5 years. So monetary value is 1/5 or 20% of the acquisition cost. Illustration. An employer purchased a car for 1 million pesos payable in 4 installments plus 10% interest on the outstanding unpaid balance of the car. The entire acquisition cost shall be recognized as monetary value since there is a transfer of ownership, but the regulation requires amortization over 5 years. Hence, the employer shall recognize 1 million divide 5 or 200,000 monetary value annually for 5 years. For quarter, the employer shall report 200,000 divide 4 or 50,000 monetary value until the cost is fully reported over 5 years. Household expense. Employee expense borne by the employer for household personnel, salaries of household help, personal driver of the employee, and other personal expenses such as homeowners association dues, garbage dues, electricity, and water are taxable fringe benefits. So the monetary value is the amount paid katong nabayad. Illustration. Hennessy Corporation granted the following benefits to a managerial employee. Salary of household personnel, 12,000 a month. Salary of personal driver, 10,000 a month. Homeowners Association dues, 4,000 a year. So the quarterly monetary value of the benefit shall be determined as follow. So salary of household personnel is 12,000 times 3, which is 36,000. Salary of personal driver, 10,000 times 3 is 30,000. And then homeowners association dues is 4,000 times 4 is divide 4 rather 1,000. So which is equals to 67,000. So a year is composed of 4 quarters. Interest on loan at least than market rate. The interest forgone by the employer representing the difference between 12% and the actual interest charge is a taxable fringe benefit. Illustration, Europa Cooperative lent its chief executive officer 1 million pesos at a minimal 3% annual interest rate. The monetary value shall be computed as follow. So the annual monetary value is 12% minus 3% times 1 million. And then, sa ubos ani is 90,000. So, wadyo ko kapalutirig yung sa niya. So, quarterly monetary value is 90,000 divide 4, which is equivalent to 22,500. So, membership fees, dues, and other expenses borne by the employer for his employees in social and athletic clubs or other similar organizations constitute taxable fringe benefit. The monetary value is the amount paid. Illustration. Mr. Jose Alfred Herbolario was appointed as the Vice President for Marketing of Baguio Gold Corporation. As his privilege, the corporation paid his Baguio Country Club membership fee amounting to 1,700,000 pesos. How much is the amount of French benefit tax? So the French benefits tax would be monetary value of membership fee, 1,700,000 divided by GMV factors, which is 68,000. Gross up monetary value, 2,500,000 and multiplied by French benefit tax rate, 32%, which is the French benefit tax and the total of 800,000. Expenses for foreign travel. Reasonable business expense for foreign travels for attending business meetings and conventions are exempt, such as the following. Inland travel expenses such as food, beverage, and local transportation costs, lodging costs in hotel or similar establishment amounting to an average of $300 a day or less, economy and business class airplane tickets, and 70% of the cost of first class ticket. Note that 30% of the cost of first class ticket in the foreign travels is considered as French benefit. Also, the following foregoing rules apply on only for foreign travels. So the cost of domestic travel is generally considered as reasonable and hence deductible. Illustration. Mr. Leonardo de la Cruz as the Vice President for Finance of Cordillera Corporation incurred the following expenses in attending a 3-day foreign business convention. Plane ticket, which is a USA travel. So first class, which is $1,500. Economy, $800. Hotel accommodation, $8,000. Inland travel, $1,500. And assume $1 is equivalent to 40 pesos. So, holiday and vacation expense. Holiday and vacation expense are taxable French benefit if shouldered by the employer. So, the monetary value is the amount paid or shouldered by the employer. So, illustration. In San Miguel Corporation provided a 4-day free vacation in Boracay to all of its employees, of which 80% are rank and file. total expenses incurred by the company for the said vacation amounted to 2 million pesos. So the termination of fringe benefits benefit tax would entail the following computations. So fringe benefit for managerial employees is 2 million times 20% is equivalent to 400,000 divided by the gross monetary value factors, which is 68,000. So the gross up monetary value is 588,235. And then you multiply it by the tax rate, which is 32%, and the fringe benefit tax due is equivalent to 188,235. So the fringe benefit tax rate. The fringe benefit tax rate and gross up rates are as follow: includes the resident citizen, non-resident citizen, and resident alien. Katong na may illustration ako yung butang there is a screen. So employees, then the column would be residents or citizens, then non-resident aliens. So the fringe benefit tax rates of residents or citizens is 35%, and for the non-resident aliens is 25%. Then gross up rates, which is 65% and 75% for the non-resident aliens. So gross up monetary value. The basis of fringe benefit tax is gross up monetary value of the fringe benefit. So the gross up monetary value is the monetary value of fringe benefits divided by the appropriate gross up rate for the employer. The gross up monetary value is inclusive of fringe benefit tax. Illustration. Assume an employer grants a fringe benefit with monetary value of 58,500 to a resident citizen managerial employee. The gross up monetary value is computed as 58,500 divided by 65%, which is equals to 90,000. So if the employee is non-resident alien, the gross up monetary value shall computed as 58,500 divided by 75%, which is equivalent to 78,000. So illustration and the fringe benefit tax computations. So illustration one is resident citizen. In the last quarter of 2023, Alexander, a Filipino supervisory employee, was given 13,000 worth of groceries for personal use. Monetary value is 13,000 divided by gross up rate, which is 65%. Kato makita nimo sa illustration. Then gross up monetary value will be 20,000. So I multiply by the fringe benefit tax rate, which is 35%. Naragihapon sa kuan illustration, which is the fringe benefit tax is equal to 7,000. Alternatively, the fringe benefit tax can be directly computed as follow. Like, naragyan sa ubos. Kani siya? 13,000 times 35% divided by 65%. So, muna itong answer na dahil. Illustration 2. Resident alien. An offshore banking unit or UBU reimbursed the following personal expense of its non-resident managerial employee during a calendar quarter: golf club membership dues 100% in the name of the employer, which is 10,000. Then the groceries is the 50% in the name of the employer is 24,000, and homeowners association dues is 5,000. So the total will be 39,000 kay i-add raman ni sila. So the fringe benefit tax shall computed as 39,000 times 35% divided by 65%, which is equivalent to total of fringe benefit nga tax niya is 21,000. So note, personal expenses are taxable fringe benefit tax in full even if they are receipted in full or in part in the name of the employer. Illustration 2. Non-resident alien. On January 2023, cyberspace company purchased a 3 million core and designated it for the personal use of its non-resident alien executive. So the monetary value which makita ra gihapon is 3 million divide 5 times 50%, which is 300,000. Then a quarterly value, which is 300,000 divide 4, which is 75,000. So the fresh benefit tax shall computed as follows, which is 75,000 times 25% divided by 75% is equals to 25,000. So note, the French benefit tax continues to be payable for as long as the employee uses the property for personal use and or business use. Lastly, treatment of the total French benefit expense. So the total French benefit expense, including the French benefit tax expense, is a deductible expense of the employer against his gross income in the computation of his taxable income. It must be noted that the deductible French benefit expense exists only when the benefit is paid in cash or in kind. So the expense is measured at the actual cost or the tax basis of consideration given as French benefit. Then, why it is important nga ano day? Anong important today ang French benefit? So French benefit tax is a tax applied to most, though not all. So French benefit provided by an employer to their employees. French benefit can include things like company's car, health insurance, low interest loans, housing, and other perks beyond the regular salary or wages. So in summary, French benefit tax plays a crucial role in maintaining tax equity, generating government revenue, and influence both employer and employee's decision. So this tax impacts the daily life by contributing to public service and ensuring a fair taxation system, thereby supporting a balanced and functioning community. So that would be all for the French benefit tax. Thank you.